At one point in time or another, nearly every person has experienced a downturn in mood, depression, sadness, a sense of hopelessness or discouragement. And often these times have prevented us from enjoying life to its fullest, or even from doing the things that are truly important for us to accomplish. After a while, it may even seem like we know exactly when we are going to feel down, and we tell others or think to ourselves, "I feel so depressed." Yet what does that mean? What are you depressing? Or what is being depressed or lowered within you? Of course, there are many clinical definitions concerning physiological causes, body chemistry, of depression, and lots of money to be made in the business of helping people to not feel. And that sense of depression is something that people don't consciously enjoy feeling. Yet it seems to happen from time to time, and even for extended periods in some cases. Intense sadness, melancholy, and despair that disrupts a person's daily living. In factors ranging from diet to psychiatric disorders. Someplace in all of that is the sense that things aren't what we want them to be. It's difficult to get excited, and the feeling of feeling so low becomes so intense that we don't know how to get out of it all. And some people identify with it and say, "I've always been this way," dejectedly accepting a bitter belief hidden behind clinical labels of what they are and what they are not. But what if, in all of this, you are something more? And from the top down, you've experienced something pushing down upon you, depressing you, moving your emotions downward to the point that not feeling at all seems to be a good day, and feeling less than this is expected from that place of being. In many ways, feeling something might even be a relief. Think of it like this. Depression could be kind of like your emotions being stuck in sadness. And that's it. With all of the other emotional options available, some people just seem to keep going back to sadness. For one reason, or many others, it worked for a little while. But even now that you're at this point, it's probably getting a little old. And when you've been stuck, you unsurprisingly find yourself lacking flexibility. And that's one of the signs of that old depression. It used to feel bad, but maybe a little good to used to feel bad. And going down into that depression, but it's reaching that point soon where things eventually turn themselves upside down. It happens all the time in nature. There is constant change, and the laws of physics and kinetic theory explain pressure as arising from the force exerted by gas molecules impacting the walls of a container. And is it so different than compressing or depressing all of your emotions so that they build up under all of that pressure? possibly even looking for a place to go. The thought of this terrifies some people, and they don't know if it would be okay for them to experience the full range of their emotions. So they stifle them, push them down and away. And sooner or later, it's not so hard to not get excited about anything at all. And then some might think that this is it. I'm not feeling much of anything. So what is there to look forward to? Well, what if you do have permission to feel anything you want? That's right, anything. You've had it all along. All of the neurology of feeling is there, waiting for you to tap in and fire it up. But you can't do it yet. And I know for some, that's relieving to know, for now. But consider all of the emotions there are, and as many as you can think of. Yes, even those bad ones. You know, the ones that aren't right, aren't proper, aren't approved of. And you know, I don't know about you, but when I experience the same thing over and over and over again, I know that I get really bored. And if I knew that I could think of all those days in my past that I had spent moping around in depression, and I thought tomorrow, next week, next month, next year, even 10 years from now, and up until the very last day of my life, knowing that the one thing I could anticipate, the one thing that I could look forward to, is that old depression, that state of feeling sad, hopeless, or not even feeling much at all. I'd begin to imagine myself being trapped in a bland white box, with nothing to do, nothing to feel, but maybe a little sadness if I was lucky. That's hopeless. And then I'd realize that if I'm going to be caught in this box, then while I'm in this box, I can do anything without fear of affecting another person. Because it's all in my head, right? And the more that I think about the prospects of this, I become bored with how predictable everything is within this box. How predictable everything is in my life. And how predictable everything is in my mind. The same old thing again and again and again. And as I experience this boredom, it's like waiting in line at the DMV. Hours seem to pass while nothing at all happens. And you know what? When that happens, in my mind I begin to feel really angry. The kind of anger you might feel if you felt to see someone hurt a person that you care about. And I know that religions and society have pretty much conditioned us to not go there, to not feel anger, because it's assumed that you can't experience profound anger and completely control yourself. Well, I'm telling you right now, you can. And if I were you, thinking about the prospect of feeling boredom because of feeling that really old depression, I'd start to feel really angry. Go ahead, try it. You're in the white box anyways. It's just you in here. No one will ever know. And the sad truth is that not too many people care anyway. The church won't ever know. Your family won't ever know. Your friends won't ever know. Your coworkers won't ever know. So feel it in your face. Clench your jaw and furrow your brow in rage in your little white box. Kick the walls, curse, scream. Let the anger course through your body. Let everything imaginable that you hate come to mind. This is all about you, and not some time for politically correct BS that you've been pushing down inside. If something provokes you, get in its face now. You want to feel something other than hopeless and despair? Find your anger. Feel it flow through your body. Be present, and pay attention to the power it holds within. Scary, huh? I'll bet it is. Notice that fear right behind the anger. What will happen if the anger takes over? I'm not responsible for it, even though I'm sure you'd feel better if I were. That's just one of the stigmas of our society. No one wants to assume responsibilities for what we call negative emotions. So we push them down inside, not realizing that health is found in experiencing and constructively allowing emotions to flow through us while you are present. It's all yours, though. You own it. Just that inch of fear keeping you from actually doing those things that you did in your mind. You know, and it's that same inch of fear that keeps you from doing the things that are a positive response to your anger. So you can choose to direct it, or you can choose to push it deep down inside and try to not feel. But there is a positive response that you can have. Now, for me, I get really pissed off when I think of all the children in the world who go to bed hungry while tons of food is wasted every day, and farmers are paid to destroy their crops in order to regulate economic demand. I feel angry when I think of the deaths of countless innocent people from the wars of rich men who send the sons and daughters of the poor to fight on their behalf. I experience anger when I realize that very few people actually think for themselves and allow large corporations and political interests to determine a future that may not be in the best interest of humanity. And you might get angry for my opinions, and that's perfectly fine. The greatest leaders in time experienced anger that gave them the energy, the motivation to move, to stand in opposition to the injustice they experienced. For you, what is the motivating side of your anger? The stuff that's also affected by fear. Fear that can be so frustrating, because deep down inside, you know that on the other side of it, something very meaningful is waiting. Something that for you can cause you to experience empathy and compassion in the deepest way. Can you remember a specific time that maybe just for even a moment you felt as though you understood the emotional state of another person? Maybe it was a lover, a child, a sibling, or a friend. But when you think of that time, it's so intense that you would do almost anything in order to reduce their suffering. And it may even be a surprise to consider what came to mind, and to have felt so deeply for that person's well-being, and the gratitude that this person likely experienced from you. Even a sense of pride to have someone like you in their life. In experiences such as these, often profound senses of oneness are experienced. Whether it happened with someone that you were romantically involved with, or through a broader sense of the word, in a universal or platonic state of love, just caring about the well-being of another individual. And when you're caught up in the experience of something like this, brings a sense of euphoria that almost causes one to forget time. Forget the concerns of the day and just be present. In the feelings that are nearly inexplicable. A euphoria that is so pleasurable that it transcends time and space. Brings back old memories. Of the most enjoyable times. And new possibilities to add to those old memories. As you realize you can always come back to the state of being, completely present. Finding that in all of this, with just a tiny drop of courage, the kind that you can feel welling up inside of you, to go out and make more wonderful experiences just because you can. Is something that brings a new, refreshing sense of hope. And realizing that every single moment of every single day holds within it the possibility of a new experience, a new outcome that you choose to create. And in case you find that your body and mind are signaling you that it's building up pressure to apply more energy in a new direction, then remember the hope it brings to another person's life when you apply your courage and move despite that inch of fear, finding the motivating power within your being and sharing compassion with others in life. Consider all the people whose lives you have not yet affected. And when you contemplate what plans you may make or not make for the day, who else will that affect? How do you want to affect them? How do you want to feel about it? Remembering that you now know, and you know now, what the sign is for you to begin. Shake off that old emotional depression when you get bored of knowing it's going to be the same until you get angry about it and direct that energy towards making a difference in a way that is uniquely you and yours. The resources you have available to you are countless, and the right people for the right time will always seem to present themselves in your life now that you are paying attention. Coming back to this, whenever you know it's time for you to move your emotions in a new direction in creating hope and a new future,
visit www.attentionshifting.com for new programs.